Thanks for joining us this morning on Good Day Colorado, a live look at the Cathedral Basilica of the Immaculate Conception right here in Denver. Shaul Turner has been giving us live reports all morning long on locals' reactions to the new Pope. We'll hear from her a little bit later this morning. But first, more now on the election of Pope Francis I. What does this mean for the Catholic faith? Well, we're answering your questions this morning. Andre Villeneuve, professor of sacred scripture at St. John Vianney Seminary, is here with some insight this morning. Thank you for being here this morning. This is such a hot topic this morning. So many people talking about it. What a great day for Catholics, right? I mean, Pope Francis I. Let's talk about the history. A lot of firsts with this.
It is. It really is. I think it was a shock to, not just to the whole world, but to Catholics especially yesterday. I was in seminary yesterday, surrounded by 100 seminarians or so, and we were just waiting in anticipation. As the name was read out, there was this big silence. And who? Mm-hmm. And even though he was a serious contender, I guess he kind of went below the radar for a lot of people. And so quite a great surprise. And also the picking of his name, Francis, which is, of course, unheard of in the church.
With his him being elected the Pope, people are talking about he's not an insider. He wasn't a Vatican insider. That's why it was somewhat of a surprise. With him not being an insider, one of the challenges he might face is perhaps cleaning house at the Vatican. There's been stories of corruption and things like that. What do you think he's going to be doing as Pope in the Vatican regarding corruption?
Well, the first thing I think we need to say is that stories regarding corruption are not necessarily corruption. And so since the Vatican is, we would say, it's both a divine and a human organization, of course it's not going to be perfect. There are going to be things always need for reform. On the one hand, it's said that being an outsider, he might bring this new, we might say, fresh air. He might, certainly he's going to bring some change. He's a new pope. On the other hand, we need to be careful and sometimes a little prudent with what we hear about what's the alleged things going on in the Vatican.
And one of the things, too, we're talking about, Pope Benedict was really consumed. His papacy was really full of this, the sex abuse scandals. Mm-hmm. So much talked about with this. Mm-hmm. Do you think it's going to be an issue? And how do you think it's going to be handled with Pope Francis?
Mm-hmm. I think this too, we need to keep things in perspective. The sex scandals are obviously a very serious matter that happened in the church. On the other hand, they tend to be very much blown out of proportion. We're talking about in the United States 2-3% of priests, which is 2-3% too many, of course, something that needs to be dealt with. But in light of the wider issue of society, of the over-sexualized society, and sex abuse is happening at a much higher rate among married fathers and so on. And so I think there needs to be a certain proportion about that. Now, what he will do about it, I guess it remains for all of us to see.
And some people wondering if he might make the Catholic Church a little more liberal. People wondering if he might allow women to have, I guess, higher positions in the church. And also, this is being thrown around as far as letting priests marry. What are your thoughts on this, and do you think he's going to address it?
Well, the issue of women in the church, I think women already have substantial positions in the church. I mean, our highest saint is the Blessed Virgin Mary, and our highest vocation really is to be saints, and it's not a power play. It's not an issue of getting into high places. The ordination of women is not going to happen. This, I think, we just need to get used to, because that's defined in Catholic doctrine. Christ chose men to be his apostles, and the priesthood is intrinsically related to manhood, just as womanhood is related to a temple, a sanctuary of life. It's not that one is more important than the other. It's just two very different roles. Now, so the ordination of women is never going to happen. However, a role in leadership in women, they already have one, and I think there is certainly room for that in different positions. As far as the ordination of priests, the marriage of priests, right. Technically it's something that's not as impossible, we might say, as the ordination of women, but I don't see it happening anytime soon because it's been a very established tradition in the church.
We'll see how this one plays out. Andre, yes. Thank you so much for showing up this morning. Great insight. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right, Shauna Mendiola in now for Jennifer Broom this morning, getting us a check of that pinpoint weather forecast. Mel, I know you're excited about these warm temperatures coming our way.
Of course I am. Look, I was working in the garage yesterday. Didn't even need a